Ever wonder how these oil tankers survive deadliest storms and roughest waters on our planet? The discovery and extraction of oil have historically transformed economies, much like gold has done in the past, and it's the reason oil is often referred as black gold. Even the oil that tankers carry across the oceans is much more expensive than the tankers themselves. From unpredictable weather systems to waves that can reach heights of up to 40 to 50 feet, oil tankers and its crew face countless challenges and immense pressure as they transport millions of barrels of oil across the globe. But how do they do it? What makes it possible for these tankers to endure the harsh conditions of the powerful oceans? And in case of a disaster, what happens to the crew? Find out on our channel, The Curious Corner. Whether it's the negligence of the crew or harsh environment of the sea. Since the early 20th century, almost 70 oil tankers have sunk, leading to devastating impacts on marine environment. After each incident, technology has continued to improve, and today, oil tankers are engineered to withstand extreme weather. Their hulls are constructed with robust materials that resist corrosion and impact, ensuring they remain seaworthy even in the harshest conditions. After the ballast system was introduced in the 1990s, the incident rate was massively reduced. The ballast tanks were installed in the tanker to enhance stability by adjusting the weight. The attached ballast tanks are filled with seawater to increase the weight of the tanker, and to decrease it, the seawater is released back in the sea. Controlling the center of gravity makes the tanker less likely to tip over in rough seas, helping it handle large waves and maintain balance even during storms. Strict maintenance schedules and inspections help ensure that all systems, including pumps, hull integrity, and safety equipment are functioning properly. Shipping companies often have policies that dictate when to avoid sailing in particularly adverse conditions, prioritizing safety. But still, before departure, crews analyze the intended route to identify potential hazards and alter it if necessary to avoid rough seas. Tankers are equipped with satellite communication systems that provide real-time updates on weather patterns, and meteorological tools are used to monitor conditions. However, if a storm approaches quickly, there may not be enough time to alter course, as navigating through busy shipping routes or shallow waters can restrict a tanker's ability to maneuver away from impending storms. The crews undergo extensive training to handle storms and emergencies. They participate in regular drills that simulate various emergency scenarios, including severe weather conditions. This helps them practice their response to high winds, rough seas, and other challenges. If the tanker approaches a powerful storm, it's the crew's responsibility to secure all cargo and equipment to prevent shifting, which could destabilize the tanker. By frequently adjusting the ballast systems and by maintaining the engine power, crews manage to maneuver the ship and maintain control, especially when facing large waves. In most cases, positioning the ship to face the waves can reduce the risk of capsizing and helps to minimize damage. However, in worst cases, changing the route or abandoning the ship might be the best option. Although the sinking of an oil tanker is a rare occurrence these days, every year over 150 oil and chemical spills happen in the United States alone. In most cases, corrosion, fatigue, or damage to the hull can lead to leaks due to rough weather. And for that, ship owners and operators are generally held accountable for maintaining the vessel and ensuring compliance with safety regulations. As oil is one of the most valuable products in the world, there is immense pressure from the oil industries, and one cannot just simply blame on the bad weather in most cases. If human error is a factor, the crew may be implicated in the incident. Governments and maritime organizations set safety standards. If they fail to enforce regulations, they might share responsibility too. However, insurance companies may cover damages and liabilities, but they will also seek to recover costs from those deemed responsible. And also, in some countries, the laws are much more strict, and the crew can also face a sentence. But the real question is, why do people apply for a frustrating job like this, which can not only cost them their lives, but can also give them a financial burden or can permanently cancel their license? Jobs on oil tankers often offer higher salaries and benefits compared to many other maritime roles. Many crew members see it as a stepping stone to higher positions in other sectors of shipping and logistics. Huge companies invest in rigorous training programs that equip crew members to handle emergencies and minimize risks. In many regions, there may be limited employment options, making maritime work a viable choice. And also, for some people, working on tankers is an exciting career that allows them to travel and experience different cultures. While human error can lead to serious consequences, the industry emphasizes safety and risk management. Crew members often take pride in their ability to operate safely and professionally. Thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe our channel, The Curious Corner.